Thank you, Tony and Pinky, again. Well, in a few seconds, we will present to you. Medyo hinila lang natin ito sa session hall. Eh. So, if you will bear with us, he's being prepped to face the camera. But, well, we ask for Atty. Esguerra. Atty. Esguerra, good evening. Good evening.
Good
Sorry,
evening,
pasensya na at nahila namin kayo bago kayo umalis.
Pasensya na rin po.
Earlier, of course, pinag-uusapan natin doon sa Basa Gidote issue muna. No? The two issues that came up today, the Basa Gidote Enterprises loan and then of course yung sa The Column. So doon muna tayo sa Basa Gidote. Ano ba ang gustong at least patunayan nyo on your side, you know, because they're trying to point out na dead na itong company na ito.
Wala naman kaming gustong patunayan kasi irrelevant. Eh. So malinaw naman sa amin from the very beginning, irrelevant. The important thing, however, is that if you're talking about the allegation on the failure to disclose under Article 2 of the impeachment complaint, then it's very clear to us that a liability or under that particular column on liability, a liability has been declared and disclosed therefore by the Chief Justice. And it went on until I think after so many years, 6 years, you know, there was no longer any entry about the liability. Now, if they want to look at I think they want to go further and establish that Basa Gidote having, its license having been revoked, no? It was no longer in existence from the legal standpoint. But it has been established during the, you know, during the discussion upon questions propounded by our senator judges that, you know, a corporation, notwithstanding the revocation of its license, can go on collecting money or even paying its debts. So that's the point. And then some of the senators were very, very forthright in saying that it doesn't matter. I mean, you know, this is actually irrelevant insofar as this particular issue on the SALN is concerned. LABT has been declared. Apparently, it has been paid over the years. So that's basically it. So to us, whatever happened to that company, Basa Gidote, is actually irrelevant.
Sir, I guess ang pinuputo nga kasi ng prosecution dito, kung hindi na nag-ooperate yung kumpanya dahil na-revoke na nga ng SEC yung license, eh wala na itong siguro, wala na siyang pera, kumbaga hindi na kumikita, wala nang pera para makapagpautang. So, parang they're already casting doubts on where that 11 million loan could have come from.
But the burden is on them to prove that there was no legitimate source. And remember that in the cross-examination by Justice Cuevas, we were able to show that Basa Gidote has an asset in Manila, the city of Manila, which has been expropriated by the city government. And 34 million plus has been paid to the company out of that expropriation. So the issue is, can Basa Gidote, as owner of this property, receive the amount by way of compensation for the expropriation of expropriated lot? Definitely it can. Now, it would appear that on the basis of the check, it has been in the name, the pay, you know, it is the name appearing there is Corona, Christina Corona, Mrs. Corona, in trust for Basa Gidote. That means all the stockholders of Basa Gidote.
Siguro ito, and procedurally, ano, inisip ko lang kasi ang pagkakasabi sa atin is that it's the turn of the prosecution to show, to provide, present evidence and witnesses. But at the same time, the defense is already starting to show some of its evidence.
Well, to the extent that we can elicit some admissions from the witness, why not? To the extent that we can, in the course of the examination, produce for the consideration, at least, of the Senate, sitting in impeachment court, this document, so that we will be aware and we will stop speculating already as to the source of the 11 million.
It was actually the first time, it was your first document that the defense itself presented as parang evidence.
Yes, there was an opportunity on the part of the good justice, Justice Cuevas, to be able to, you know, elicit that, I mean, bring that out, and so we were able to bring that particular document out.
I just along that line, I was also quite impressed how the defense was able to slip that in, that essentially, we're establishing your defense, no? Although it's not yet your turn, by showing that check, and also in regard by showing those letters in regard this the Ayala the property. Mm. Did you know that she had those documents with her, or was it just on the basis of that slip of paper that you saw in relation to the documents they were presenting?
They pre-marked certain documents, mm-hmm. and we were able to review them. Mm-hmm. And we were looking for other documents, mm-hmm. especially the exchange of communication,
yes.
about the what to us was a problem about the unit.
Mm-hmm.
But I saw that there was a covering handwritten memo, mm-hmm. By Mrs. Corona addressed to the developer Community Innovations, and I read through. I mean, I sneaked. Was able to see that it was somehow to my appreciation adverse to them,
mm-hmm.
and so I just protected that particular document. Not really to say that they are going to tamper with that document, mm-hmm. but you know, as as a litigator with a little experience, you have to be quick. Mm-hmm. You know, if that particular opportunity mm-hmm. presents itself, mm-hmm. and it did, mm-hmm. and so we had that mark, and we went on with the cross examination. Mm-hmm.
But of course, during the questions propounded by the senator judges, eh, si Senator Dilo naman was able to elicit from the witness na yung susi daw ng condominium unit ay nakay na Mrs. Corona na.
Only in 2011.
Only in
we will prove that. We will prove that. I cannot ask the witness to identify that last letter, mm-hmm. handwritten by Mrs. Corona, because the witness does not know.
You are referring to that letter to the board of directors
of the homeowners association.
Okay.
Actually,
okay.
It's on the issue on the association use, and Mrs. Corona in that letter, as we will show later when mm-hmm. our turn comes, that there was really a problem. You know, mm-hmm. So many issues about the unit.
Okay.
Why they were not able to pay the association use?
Okay, so may pasilip na pala ng magiging sagot ng depensa dito. Tony and Pinky, baka may tanong pa kayo kay Attorney Esguerra.
Magpapaalam na muna tayo kay Attorney Esguerra. Dahil mabuti nga yan.
Salamat.
Mabuti nga yan at nahilan niyo pa si Attorney Esguerra.
Oo nga.
Yung isang paa nasa Mall of Asia na ata kanina.
Naibalik
pa.
Maraming salamat
po, Attorney Esguerra.
Okay, God bless you.
Thank you so much.
All right. Well, thank you very much as well to Attorney Esguerra. At medyo kanina, pagpasensyahan niyo po kami ni Pinky, medyo nalito kami dahil nabanggit na namin, tatlo yung naging witness today. Munting na pala.